A key speaker during the consultations was civil engineer and consultant Michelle Tonioli of the Exploration Management Consultant, EMC, which will be responsible for the design, technical support and monitoring and supervision of the exploratory drilling program. Mr. Tonioli explained the EMC's commitment to the highest standard of environmental protection.
So our company has an extensive experience all around the world in geothermal projects. So we are confident that this project will be very helpful to get information with a minimal impact on the environment, on the communities. So our intention just to arrange a design with special care for the communities and for the environment.
Mr. Tonioli, along with members of the project implementation team, conducted a thorough briefing of the upcoming project activities with the community. Suzanne Haim, principal co-owner of Panorama Environmental Incorporated and the environmental and social impact assessment specialist and project manager, outlined the consultant team's plan for further assessment of the environmental and social impacts within the project-affected communities.
So what we do is at the start of the project, we're going to go out to each of these sites and look at them, and we're going to evaluate what are the biological resources, what sort of natural habitats are there, what's the air quality like. Are there any geological resources that we should be aware of, things like fractures that we should be aware of? What are the cultural resources? And what's our social conditions? What's the community like? What are the demographics? What are the economics in that community? And so we use that as a baseline. And we say, okay, this is where we start. This is what happens before the project. And then we look at what is going to happen as part of the project, both during construction, and if there's any testing that's happening here, we'll look at both the well drilling and the testing, and we'll look at what sort of impacts could that have. This project is temporary, so it's not a forever project. It's not a project that has an operational life, but we will evaluate, is there any risk to longer term issues that could result from the project? And what we'll do is we're gonna apply international standards to define mitigation measures that will be implemented during the construction and testing process to make sure that the environmental conditions that are there at the site are protected, that the economic conditions for the community are protected, that there is proper compensation for anyone who is affected.
One of the main concerns expressed during the consultations was fair compensation for residents directly impacted by the project's construction requirements. Ms. Haim expressed the following reassurances.
During the abbreviated resettlement action plan process, we will be coming to the communities and we will be looking at what is the actual valuation of anyone who is affected and making sure that everyone gets just compensation. So those parties who have land where there's going to be access road improvements or the well pad, if they have any structures on those properties, they will be compensated fairly and will be made better off. And then with the environmental impact measures, we will also be doing things like monitoring air quality, monitoring water quality. This will actually become a basis of information for future projects and future generations.
Members of the community expressed appreciation for the level of engagement that the RESDP has initiated and the willingness of the project implementation team and consultants to be transparent and share in detail all of the project activities and expectations.
The presentation was very informative. Although I've been to most of the meetings and a lot of the information was not new, but for the benefit of those who have not attended, or maybe they're attending for the second time, I think it was very informative.
I think the presentation was extremely good. I've been to others in the past, and I notice every time the numbers are increasing. So this in itself would be a very good initiative in the community. Yes, it is something new, but I realize also a lot more persons are aware. So every time there's a meeting, a lot of persons are turning out. So they are looking forward to something good in the community.
With the exploration management consultant's direction, the project has already made significant strides in both research and the preliminary exploration phases. In addition to technical exploration, the RESDP and the EMC is committed to fostering community engagement, ensuring that local stakeholders are involved in the development process.